Okay, so my name's Mike. This is my season with Boca Juniors in the Premiership. I always play with Boca Juniors because of the La Bombonera, great stadium, really. And I suppose it's a bit boring, really, playing with English clubs. But anyway, I play on pro level, pretty good on virtual pro. On regular games, just okay. Anyway, let's just have a look through the team. If you play with Boca Juniors, you will find out that when you start, a lot of the players start off on loan, in fact. So let's have a look to see which players are already out. So as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 players who are out on loan. That's at the start of the season. And of course, in true style, FIFA style, some of the best players are actually on loan, which is Paredes, and I'm not sure how to pronounce that because I've never played him, Rajo. So as you can see, I've put one player on transfer list. Pretty mixed bag, really. Most of them are around early 70s, late 60s. Well, the frontline players tend to be 70 to 75. The back players tend to be 65 to 70. As we can see, though, as well, another amount of players who've got loaned in. We are near Christmas, so some of these are my signings. Monzon is the lonely, as is Perez. Dani Osvaldo, the Southampton player, who I think this season's probably played about 20 games and not scored any. Here we have the three players that I have brought in this season. Anthony Marshall, which I just scouted on the back of you know, his name popping up in the scout report. I know he's good in previous seasons, didn't realize he was still good in this one, so I've got him. Hopefully I can buy him at the end of this season. I'm going to try that. Rafinha, which is a Barcelona B player, who have played with pretty good on the ball dribbling, but been a bit underwhelmed, really, with playing with him. Menga, a guy who's got blistering pace, no control, and he's another loan here. That was a panic one, really, because Osvaldo, in fact, if I sort out the players into the positions, you can probably have a look a little bit better on what we've got up front. Osvaldo, 77, not bad, but I find it difficult to play with him. It's a bit static, really. Caleri, who have played with a bit, not that great. Neil Malpe, who I bought off a scout report. I don't know how much I paid for him, but he was the one that, I suppose, I believe he's pretty good in the game. So I scouted loads of players. It's pretty easy once you know which players to scout, which ones to pick out with, you know, great potential, exciting prospect, potential to be special. So I've got quite a full squad. The idea is, I'm hoping at this January transfer window that I can kind of overhaul it a bit, shift a few players out and bring in a couple of the youngsters that I've spotted with. At this moment, my youth academy has got about three players in. Well, four, there we go. Cunha is one of the players that have come through the catalogue, the Scout of Future Star. So he's looking like he's going to be blistering, he is. Ravel, not sure he's going to make it, but I love playing with players who are like 6'5" in defence. You can get away with them being about 75 to 80 in defence because they win that many air balls. Diaz, not sure, he's looking about what, 85 maybe. He's only 5'3" though, and age 15. Guy here, another Argentinian guy I've signed, Guado. Again, he's looking like he's going to be about 85, 86 maybe. Maybe not that much, maybe 82, but 5'5", and one of his positions is defence, so I'm not sure what position he's going to play, if he makes it, of course. So I think that's an overview. Let's let have a look, see where I am in the table. I think I'm 12th. I'm also in the Champions League, which I put that on as part of the start of the season. I think that's important because I think Boca Juniors have about 6 million starting with crap scouts, no good youth guys, so I basically spending money on signing the youth guy. I don't really want to go into the buy a billionaire because I'd be really honest with you, I want to play with players that I haven't played with before. Where's my group? There we go, top of the league after I lost to Benfica. down. I think I drew with the A's, I'm not sure, but anyway, got through there. So, well, and I'm through to the semi-finals in the Capital One Cup where I play United. Okay, this is, I think, the summary so far. Okay, I thought I'd have a look at the squad. This is my position, really. Goalkeeper, I could really do with a goalkeeper. 33, Ryan. Possibly could sell him, really. 3 million could do with that cash. Reserve goalkeeper's good enough. Centre backs, Bidisso, 26, 71. That's a no, really, isn't it? I'll keep him because I've not really got much cover at this position at the moment. Diaz is deteriorating quickly, great stats, but when players like that, usually I play somebody, you'll get benefits from playing. So, for example, Magalan, who is one of my players, yeah, an exciting prospect, so this allowed transfer bids from him. So I'm going to keep with him, 93 jumping. He's only 5'11", which usually is a bit of a problem for me with centre-backs, but he does seem to win some balls. He's not dominant, really, yet. Perez, who's loaned out, can't see me doing anything with him when he comes back in. He's the loanee, so barely playing. He's one of the guys they already got. I've just signed him to an extension contract deal. Not a particularly great player, but because I'm desperate, 6'3", 90 strength, he is dominant pretty much, except he's easy to beat, dribble past. So I'll keep him with a view to probably selling him in the summer if I've signed some good youngsters. Left back, which is odd here that they would loan out two left backs. Why would you loan out two and then loan one in? A veteran, I don't know, maybe that's what they do. So Monson's a loanee. Neither of those two prospects really are thrilling me coming into the team. So I might look at a left back as well. But at the moment, I think probably goalkeeper, two centre backs. Right back, happy with those, Marin. I played with him before in last year's and he developed okay. He seems to be picking up lots of progress this year. Peruzzi, kept him, but I'm not sure. We'll see how he goes. I don't think he's developing really at the moment. Central attacking midfielder, so here's the same issue really with before. So look how many loanees and loan outs. So loaned out, come back 70, 20, not particularly great, but he's free. Already with the team, so might have a look at Castellini. I played with it and he's touch off the ball is rubbish, so put him on the list. Another guy loaned out, 21.66, not sure. Madeiro, very tempted to sell him, just if we can pick up somebody good in this window. But I have enjoyed playing with him. He's really he's played quite well this season. 5 million though, tempting to go in the bank. Paredes, who's on loan, so if I sell somebody for a lot, I might actually bring him back. I think the cost is 360,000. So if I can get some money off these transfer sales, I will bring him back in. Rafinha, talked about the Barcelona guy. It's been okay. Alvarez, 22.64. Can't see him doing anything when he comes back. Oh, Bazoa is a guy who I picked up off the scouting. Understanding he develops pretty well, so I think I'll end on my feet there. I've really played with him as the CDM. Cubas, I've transfer listed him pretty much because his work rate is low and medium, just not good enough really. It's a shame because in the squad report he seems to be picking up lots of skills. Urbez, I've just put him on a transfer list. He is probably my strongest defensive midfielder, but when I play with him he's quite small. I think 5'8", and it's okay. But for 2.6 million, that's too good to pass up. Can't see him getting back into the team when he comes back, Ferreira. Central midfielders. I played 4-4-2 diamond at the moment, so not planning to change that yet. I might go to 3-5-2 actually. But you tend to pick up lots of good fullbacks, don't you? When you scout for players, so I might hold back on going to. I normally play 3-5-2 against the computer, just because I like to dominate the possession really. Melee, I've not really played with him much, but I'm going to keep hold of him at the moment. 22 and 72 is too good. Bravo, I should say I keep him because I've played with him before in the past and he does develop reasonably well. He seems to pick up a lot of skills quite quickly, and he's strong as well. Let's have a look at his skills. It doesn't say he's that strong, does it, though? Hang on. I know he's got high defensive work rate, not particularly speedy or anything like that. His interception 67, not great at the moment. tackling, 68, 65, not great, but it's that low and high. He does seem to be comfortable on the ball. I think it's probably because of his strength, 17. So I think looking forward, I don't want to get another CDM because I've got Brazil, unless I go to a 3-5-2 or something along those lines. I might then look at another CDM, but at the moment I'm quite happy with him. Bravo, I'll probably go with him as the backup. Left wingers, they're pretty good actually. Carrizo, I kind of keep hold of him just because I don't really want to be wasting too much money on getting new players in. Chavez, he really plays as a striker, stroke left winger. I like playing with him up front. He's quite speedy. He's also quite strong as well. I can see sprint speed, his strength, acceleration. For a guy who's 6 foot, that's quite handy, isn't it? I think he's a good high medium as well. Yeah, high medium, long shot taker. His ball control, not particularly great, and I don't think he shoots. I think he shoots about 70 or something, isn't it? Finishing 74, long shot 76 and 83, so yeah, it's definitely worth keeping hold of. Pavon, 18 and 63, I'll just keep hold of him because he's one of the kids coming through. Lolone Fernandez, don't think he's got a future here, 23-68. I've got two players who are similar, Cristaldo and Pavon. Again, I'm just going to keep hold of them because they're youngsters. Fuenzalida, I am playing with him at the moment because he's got an engine as one of his skills, so he can also play right back and right wing. Stamina 90, and that's, I think, for me essential in that position. So I'll keep holding him. He seems to play okay. Strikers, if you look, Osvaldo's not mine, Wenger's not mine, Marshall's not mine. Guys loaned out, so he's got a potential for future. I like that 21-73, but when I look at this guy's stats, Caleri, excuse me. He doesn't thrill me. I like the high and medium, but there's nothing there that's really separating him out really from the rest. So I won't put him on the transfer list unless I can pick up somebody in this window. Anthony Marshall, like I said, I'm going to try and get hold of him. What I really need, probably, I think, looking at that, is a big, tall striker. Probably an attacking midfielder. Two centre backs and a goalie. I think that's what I'll look for in this window. And the players that I've got an absolute ton on my shortlist. Screw for it, I can't pay 8 million for a goalkeeper, not even at age 18. It's maybe a better bet. No, maybe not actually. I'll tell you what, I'll get rid of him off my shortlist. Tim showing great potential. There's a potential maybe get him 19 and 70. What's the guys I've got? Peruzzi and Marin. I think I might hold on to see what Marin does before going for right back. Centre backs, I suppose John Stones, but he's not going to come. There's a few here that I've looked at. No way, can't afford him. I think he's supposed to be really good. City player, or City, I think he's left City now, Gary Mekic. Sven van Beek, but 9 million, really shite. I'll have to take him off. Look at that. No, okay. See, I like guys who are big and strong in the air. 77 acceleration, 79. What's his, how tall is he? 6'2", that guy looks too good to pass up, doesn't he? But I can't afford 9 million. I've got 10 million in the transfer kitty plus wages on top of that, but I think wages are about 20,000, so not that much. So really, these are the kind of guys I'm going to be looking at. Kostas, Mekic, maybe Stones, although I've not quite about him. I'm guessing he's probably going to be about 8 million. Might be able to steal Jimenez. Suter, he's supposed to be really good, isn't he? And Suter, 6 million, can't afford that. So I might go for, I think I'm going to go for Suter. I can get some games out of him without warning out. I think I'd be comfortable playing with a guy 75, 77 speed, even with that poor interceptions, 6'1". Not particularly strong, stamina, okay. That's a bit of a, not seen him before, not noticed him. 6'2", 83 jumping, he's a bit slow. Good interceptions, might be worth a look at that price. 20. Okay, left backs. I'm not going to look for a left back, I don't think. I should scout him. Johnny, that's a good name, isn't it, for a full back? Not showing anything. There's time to get rid of him. Whoa, look at that guy. Mm. 94 stamina, 93 aggression. Quite fast, we'll see. We'll have a scout in him anyway. Danilio, 1872. He looks like he could be pretty good. 6 foot as well, 68, 65 for speed. Anyway, right, don't want my midfield to do good on that side. Central midfielders, I thought I'd scouted him. Okay, I'll tell you what, I'll just have a quick flip through. You can see the guys who are on my list. If you're ones that you're looking at, 8 million for Will Hughes, so he's off the. Can't buy him. None of the guys who I'm looking for really I can buy, can I? I've heard he's really good, this guy, but he's got a low defensive work rate, and that's not great for me. I like guys who've got high work rates. Medium, he's got flair, possibly. Okay, so there's a good number of youngsters that can probably look at. Oliver Towers have played in the last game, and he was great on the ball with his passing, but not particularly strong, or didn't have loads of stamina, so he didn't last the pace. 17 and 17, that's too good, isn't it? 20, 77, oh, maybe that's the guy. 84 acceleration, 86 vision. I think that's the guy. Dribble playmaker. Have a look at him. Croatian, okay. Brandon Barker, got him with the City guy. City kid is supposed to be pretty good. Doesn't really show in anything this game, but keep it interesting. Januzaj, he's supposed to be really good in this game. Not sure I can be bothered playing with him. A couple of decent midfielders. And here's the guys that we like looking at, isn't it? Correa, who we've had in previous games. I think he's got low defensive work rate, but he's a great dribbler. Setting up play, really, 1975. Barkley, thought I'd have a look at 25 million. He's straight off the shortlist, isn't he? Lucas Anderson, 2073, looks good. 1970, yeah. Mine's supposed to be really good. I played with him before, though. Can't afford 10 million, so that's out. Played with him before, wasn't mad on him. That was in the earlier games. Wow, that guy's the guy. He's the steal, isn't he? 6.5 million. 2078. Ah, they're not going to sell him. But yeah. Maximiliano, 2075. 2073, Jose Rodriguez. Denis Suarez is the other guy I'm looking at. Ah, he's on loan. Bernard Mensah, he's supposed to be really great. 8.5 million, though. I can't afford that. So he's another one who's gone. I listen to this guy. That's not bad, is it? Attack position is good. Ball control, dribbling, that'll improve. Brazilian 6'2". Acceleration 73. So, maybe. Nabai Yang is supposed to be great. He's on loan, so that's another guy I can't buy. Carlos Mane, 86. Oh, he's tempting, isn't he? Especially 81 dribbling and that agility and sprint speed balance. Not really great strength, okay. Danny Ings got him because I think he's high on his. Yeah. So might look at him. 77 finishing, that's pretty good. He's only 2 million. Plus whatever they want. 2070. That might be the guy I go for. Hector Villalba. What's his size? 5'8". Okay, not a great finisher either as well. Played with Jurgen Lacaria, so I think he's a great potential sign. He's a real handful. Or he was in previous games. But I want to try somebody different, so we'll not play with him. Origi, the Liverpool guy. Oh, that's potential 2.6. I think he's on loan, isn't it? Yep, so he's kind of off it. 2069, 6 million. No chance, pal. Not paying that. Jose Luis Sierra, who I understand gets pretty good in the game, so I might have a look at him. I think 6 foot. He's already 72 jumping. This is age 17. Not great stamina. Not good. There's loads of room for development with him. I think I might have a look at him. He's only cheap. He's a guy I could easily sign and then put in, you know, loan out. Zivkovic, I think he's supposed to be pretty good. He's showing up as reasonably good. Oh, he's okay. James Wilson is another guy. I think he's supposed to develop pretty good, but I think is he low or medium? Or medium, medium. Okay, so maybe 6 foot, 81 and 84 speed. Maybe. 54, 17, 66, 19. Can he get 12 in 2 years? Yeah, I think he can develop that way. It's actually not worth. So I should probably take him off. Actually. Maxwell Cornet, he's the guy I definitely want. Every time I've tried to buy him, they've said he's not for sale. So let's see if he is for sale. Svensson, he's supposed to be pretty good, but that's a flare, isn't it? I don't really think I want to be bothering running a risk on a 57-17 guy, so he can go. I know he's supposed to be good, but I just scouted him. 17, 61, 6 foot 4, 69 acceleration, 69 speed. I'll tell you what, I'll keep on my list, it's a possibility. And then left wingers, Memphis Depay, just look the look of him, but 31 million, he's off. I think maybe I might up the game from professional. I've only just got it a few weeks ago, so just trying it now. Julian Brandt, I might have a look at him actually because he looks good, doesn't he? Medium, medium. He can play across the front three though. Victor Fisher, 75-20. He looks a bit more tempting. Well, maybe not. Okay, so that's the list. I'm just going to have a look at some signings and come back later. Okay, so I've just tidied up my shortlist. I have bid for a couple of players. As you can see, I've bid for Jimenez, although they're asking for between something like 6 and 9 million, with the budget being 10 million, I'll be honest with you, I'm more inclined to spend money on getting a good youth scout for my academy. Stones is the same, about 6 or 8 million they're asking. Rekic is on loan, so I can't bid for him. Suter, put a bid in, just under the 500,000, hopefully pick him up. Vezo is I haven't bid for him. How much are they asking? See, 5-7 million. I'm not sure what I blow on my budget on that. You see, I would rather get a good scout work and pick up maybe two good youngsters and think long term. I mean, this season I'm in the Champions League because I started in the Champions League, give me a bit of a boost qualifying for the group stages. And I don't really want to. Well, I want to get some more money from that. I'm going to have to pay all these youngsters, probably pay off a few contracts. But really, maybe buy the odd good player, and I can't really afford it at the moment. I don't think it's worth buying. Splodging my whole 10 million just on one player. Fullbacks, I'm not desperate for, unless we can get him for a cheap price, I'll help him. Saul, I looked at him, he's a possibility. But as you can see, I've cut down the midfielders. I'll scan this guy because he's got 93 aggression. And I think the looks of that, you know, age 19, he could be phenomenal, especially with 90 odd stamina. Right wingers, again, I'm not desperate for them. I think Dulafiu, he's on loan. I'm scouting Gilbert Murrow. I think I did scout him earlier in the season and they wouldn't sell to me because he's from Estudiantes, which is in the Argentinian Primera Division. And they weren't interested in selling him to me, even though I'm based in the Premier League now. These are the guys I've inquired about. Halilovic, just because he's an exciting prospect. So I've seen how much they want for him. Same with this guy because of the jumping strength and stamina. Okay, it's not great on anything. The technical skills at age 20, you could easily pick them up. I just like the, you know, the physical aspect of, you know, his game. Ledson, I've put a bid in because I understand he's pretty good, so I've just asked how much they want for him. I'm quite happy to splodge money on him.
I have asked about how much Torres they want for Torres. I'm guessing they'll come back with 7 million or something. This guy, I'm gonna. I think I've put a bid in. Oh no, I've asked them how much they want. But 70 at 17. The Croatian guy, isn't he? I think. Portugal. I think I'm gonna have a look at him. Just because he looks pretty good for that age. Again, I put a bid in 77, age 20. Oh, I've inquired about him. I've got a feeling they're going to come back with 11, 12 million for him. Again, not desperate for wingers, although I have looked at Werner because 90 acceleration, 90 speed, age 18, 70, and he's only a million, so I'll see if we can pick him up. I asked about Carrera. I'm guessing they're going to ask for a load. I've just kept a couple of these other guys on because they look brilliant, although there's no way I'm going to be able to afford him this season. I might look at him next season. Niang, I'm going to scout him to see how much, what he's like. I understand he's pretty good. But again, I'm not desperate for midfielders. I have inquired to see how much they want about it. Mane, again, same. I think the thing with him is he's all speed and everything like that. I'm not sure he's going to be that easy to play with. What's his work rate like? High, medium, okay, and he plays left and right. So it's a possibility for him. But again, I'm not desperate for wingers. Strikers, I have asked how much they want for Cornet. I don't know if I've asked. No, that's it. He won't come, will he? I put a bid in for the Chilean guy. So I might just pick up two small forwards. Again, left wingers, I don't think I've put any bids in. Maybe I've asked maybe how much Brandt will cost. The other two guys, come by me, he's great, isn't he? But he's not going to come. Let's see how much they're going to ask for him. Oh no, it doesn't say. He's not got much scope, I suppose, 78. Well, maybe he will. Those physical aspects are good, aren't they? Okay, so that's where we are. And I'll just go a little bit into my formation. Not so much the formation, the tactics. I use a custom tactic, and just to show you, if you don't play with custom tactics, highly recommend getting sorting yourself out. I always play the speed, slow speed, short passing. Really just a possession game, and also cut down on the risky passes. I think I've gone a bit over the top there. I might reduce that to 20. The idea is that I kind of build up a kind of Barcelona kind of passing game. I play with high pressure and aggression because if I don't, I find that I give the computer too much space in front of my back four, and my back four are too far removed from the rest of the players. So I try to play relatively high up. I might even push that up to 70. To play high, because the computer doesn't seem to play that many long balls through. In fact, we'll go on 70. That'll do. And we'll do the same with that. So we can play a higher game up the field. Okay. I'm going to go into the games. Thank you.
Great. Well, this is how the home team shape up. City make three alterations to that last line. Lucas Fabianski plays in goal. Ashley Williams plays. Lodero, and he gets it back again quickly. Shots on here, kept out by got to be keeper. Really stretched, and he's made a fine diving save. Corner. Away by the goalkeeper's punch. Oh, he's got a block in there. The game stopped by referee Anthony Taylor. EA Sports continues its coverage from the Barclays Premier League. The fixture, Swansea City. They'll be facing Hull City away from home.
Yeah, I've had a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well.
Leon Britton, return pass. Wayne Routledge. And he shoots. And he was in with a real opportunity here, and then just fell away.
Yeah, just falling as he was about to strike, and I don't think any...
To the player by the opposition. Nathan Dyer. Britton. Here's the chance. Just over.
Lodero.
Here's the shot. Taylor. Wayne Routledge. Chance to get the ball in the box. He's got to cross it.
Straightforward stop from an effort from a long, long way out.
Osvaldo.
Was a very well contested first half, and this is the start of the second half. Wayne Routledge, and the cross is in.
Gomez! Oh, he's gone, and what a first season he's having.
Yeah, just at the right moment for him. Might be a big goal in this football match.
It's over the line, off the underside of the bar. Goal!
I think the keeper thought he might get a hand on this, but no chance in the end.
We're all level again. 1-1 the score.
Absolutely no trouble for the goalkeeper here to save that shot from distance.
Organisation there in the face of a promising move. Just in time, in the end, a fantastic clearance. Well, that's widened the game here, and they've got it to the wide man well. Well, he tried to get the ball wide, but it's been cut out. Pablo Osvaldo. It's a chance, got to be. They're still
clear the ball. Oh, no!
Seemingly the moment they would go in front. It didn't quite pan out that way. The Swansea City, a change coming up. Keeps it going well. That's no problem for the goalkeeper, it's straight at him. That's in the match, really. And the manager here not settling for level pegging. He's going to try and do something to put his team into the lead. Nathan Dyer.
And here's the shot.
Goal here could be absolutely crucial. It would put them in front, of course. Giorgio Shelvey. Herbes. Into the attacking third.
Here's the chance.
Great pass from the goalkeeper.
Canisa. Driving really hard for the goal that surely will give them the victory here. But the time is against them. Sigurdsson. Well, neither side could get the decisive goal. There it is, the game is over, and the final score is 1-1.